When is probably the best time to ask for seller concessions? Let's talk about it. Hey everybody, it's Rosemary Lewis, your educator agent with eXp Realty, and today we are going to continue our discussion about seller concessions, and I will share with you what is, in my opinion, one of the best times to ask for seller concessions. But before we get to it, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and follow me on social media. On Instagram, I am Rosemary the Realtor, and on Facebook, I am Rosemary Lewis. So before I told you all about seller concessions, you can find that video. I'll link it up here somewhere so that you can get to it. But basically, we know that seller concessions are a gift that the seller can contribute, a monetary gift, towards buyer closing costs. Now, when is the best time to seek seller concessions from a seller? Now, if you are a buyer, I always say you have to understand your purchasing power. That means understanding how much money you're going to be pre-approved for, but what that payment looks like and what you are going to have to bring to closing. I definitely have been in situations before where the client qualifies for the mortgage amount. The mortgage amount is comfortable and within what they're able to spend. However, sometimes the closing costs will put them a little uncomfortable with their how much cash they want to keep. So sometimes I do have clients that it is imperative that we get some seller concessions. Now, I want to preface this by saying, I'm going to give some advice here today, but it is not a blanketed advice, okay? Meaning that this advice does not cover every situation. If you are a real estate agent, you really have to do the due diligence to study the market that you're in and educate your client about that market. For instance, right now in the Dallas-Fort Worth market, our market is stabilizing, okay? In some areas, we're in more of a buyer's market, meaning that there is more inventory than there is buyers to buy the homes, right? So in a market like that, it generally leans itself for sellers to negotiate a little more and to provide assistance to your buyers for closing. But when you're in a seller's market, like 3 years ago, we were in a market where literally the minute that you put the sign in the yard, there were 20, 30 offers on any given property, and those offers exceeded the purchase price. So needless to say, those sellers were not very motivated to assist with closing costs. So my very first piece of advice is to study the market, know the market that you're in, because that is leverage that will assist you as you negotiate on your client's behalf. In addition to that, real estate agents, don't be afraid to pick up the phone and get the other agent on the phone in addition to studying the market. You want to get an idea. First of all, you want to advocate for your client. So before an offer even comes over, you want to let them know, hey, I've been working with Mr. and Mrs. Jones. They are fabulous. They have great credit. I fully underwritten them with my lender. You know, all we have to do is find the perfect home. And, you know, even before our show or before we start offering, talking about putting an offer in on your listing, I just wanted to get a little bit more information about your seller. That can go a long way, and I'm gonna tell you why. Not only are you establishing a relationship with the other agent and establishing rapport, which can definitely benefit you if you do decide to offer on a property, but a lot of times the listing agent will give you insight as to what's going on with the seller. They might say, hey, they're moving out of town, or we have a house under contract, they're very excited. You get an idea to see how motivated they are, right? So that could go a long, long way. Now, I don't want either agent to violate their fiduciary responsibilities to their clients, what they need to do to represent their clients well. I don't want you to disclose anything that will hurt your client, but definitely sometimes the listing agent will give you insight to help you understand how to draft an offer. Now, here's my big advice. If you cannot close unless the seller gives you some concessions. You definitely probably want to offer on properties that have a little bit of market time. Now, that may look different in any market, right? In some areas of the Dallas-Fort Worth area, that could be 30 days. Some areas, that could be 60 days. I just had a situation where it was a beautiful home, and it was just a little overpriced, right? So guess what happened? That home sat there, and it sat there long enough that when me and my buyer showed up, we were able to negotiate $10,000 in seller concessions. Now, I guarantee you, that very same seller would not have agreed to that amount the very first week or 2 weeks or even the first month that that home was on the market. But what happened? The longer the home sat on the market and went unsold, he had a pain point because he flipped that house. He was ready to get out of it. So his pain essentially ended up being my client's gain. So really pay attention to the market time, really study the market, and just make a very informed decision. If something's brand new to the market and they have five offers on it, probably not the best time to ask for seller concessions. Now, I will tell you, as an agent, I'm never afraid to ask for anything. And, you know, I go off of the direction of my clients because ultimately I'm working for them. But it's imperative that I do the due diligence on the back end, do the research, contact the agent, and really help them understand what's happening in the neighborhood to help us with an informed, to help us present a competitive offer, but one that is definitely in the benefit of the buyer if I'm representing the buyer. So that is my piece of advice. If you are in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and if you're looking for a real estate agent to really just help, not just guide you, but to advocate for you and to help you really understand what you're getting into, go ahead and reach out to me. My information is in the description box. And hey, if you are an agent and you just want to mastermind, you want to talk, I mean, you can be nationwide. We can Zoom, we can do whatever, just to connect, because I want to see you all successful in this business, because we want to build competent agents so that we are all out here helping people at the highest capacity. I'm Rosemary Lewis. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next week.